Hello and welcome everyone, Michael here from Atavism team. Today, in quick tutorial, I'll present you how to update Atavism server version 2018.3.1 to Atavism server version 2019.1. It is tutorial for all of you guys that using the Atavism manager for Windows. To start, we'll need to ensure that our database is topped. When we see that, we will perform the, I'll say, one of the most important part. Now we'll create some backup directory. And here we'll just copy this MariaDB. Here, this task will give us a fully working backup just in case that during your upgrade process there will be like power failure or something else happens bad to your computer. Okay, so we have the backup of the database. The next step for me will be to just rename the Atavism server. So in my case, I'll just call this 2018.3-1. So I know that's my old version. And I have on my desktop a newer version of the server. It is still release candidate, but it will be exactly the same procedure. So we'll just open this and copy the files to this new directory. So you'll need to do this task in the place where your Atavism manager is installed. Okay, so we have now new Atavism server there, but before we can run it, we need to perform a database upgrade. There are two parts of it. First of all, we need to upgrade the structure, and then we'll need to update the data. And the data and the structure will base literally on approach that we will have. We currently using the demo version of our project. If you're using core, you will need to go to the core directories. Okay, but to upgrade the database structure, we'll just need to run the command line. And just so you can see here. Okay, we need to start the database. So the database is running. We can close this window. And now we need to go to this location here. So we'll just copy this. Do the Control V. Sorry, it doesn't work. Okay, so we are here. Now, as we are here and the database is running, we will just perform these few steps here. These steps basing on assumption that number one, you didn't change the database names, so it will be a admin, Atavism, Word Content, and then there is also master. We don't will upgrade master, but that's the default names of the databases that we're providing. If you change them to different one, you just need to adjust this to your settings. And the second assumption is that your username is root and the password to the database is test. If you have different username and password, again, you will just need to change these two informations here. But so I'm using just default settings on this tutorial. We'll just copy this and the right click of mouse will paste this. So just press enter, and this part is updated. next part of the structure. I didn't copy it. Okay, there was some glitch. I think it's time to upgrade the computer. So this part, it was the last part of the structure. Now we'll upgrade the data itself. And then the last update. And we can close this window as we already finished this. Now we'll start this Atavism Manager. We can stop the database just to be sure that everything is fine. Start it again. Close this window. And here, after you change the, after you kind of replace the Atavism server folders, the configuration of the your files was also changed to default ones, so you will just need to quickly put on back your information. So your email address that you're using to log into the A-panel, your license key associated with this email address, ensure that your ports are available, that means they're currently displayed in green, that they're ready to be used by any application, but we assume we'll use this with the Atavism. Then the host name slash IP address. I showed this in one of the previous tutorials, but you can find your IP address by typing ipconfig. So in my case, it is a this IP address. So I'll just edit this and then enter. Okay, that's my kind of internal IP address. As the Atavism Manager for Windows, it's usually used by on the computers that are behind a firewall, and the people from outside will access it using your external IP address. And for that, we're using this second parameter. But in my case, when I done allowing access from internet site, I can again put on here the same local IP address. And press apply. The information about the database, most likely they are not changed. That's the end of the configuration, so we can close this window. We don't really need to look here. And we'll just start the authentication server. Again, it looks like the server say, okay, you're starting the first time. It will perform its tasks. It is just first time when it's doing this for slightly longer time. And then we can also start the Word server. Like you can see here, it's 2019.1.0. I expect it to have failure as I'm using a default email address and the license key. So here it is, the validation failed. But when you enter your valid information, valid details, it will be okay, and it will be now ready to be used by you to continue your development. Thank you for watching, and see you on next tutorial.